Interestingly, the majority of FSB members are not incorporated. They're sole traders. And yet the majority of our members want to see corporation tax powers devolved and used to reduce the rate of corporation tax. What's your position on that?
I strongly support the devolution of corporation tax. And I support it because it is proven that a low headline rate of corporation tax strengthens the entire business chain, from the large multinational who will be the primary beneficiary through to the sole trader at the bottom of that business chain. So everyone wins with a lower headline rate. And for that reason, I think it is would be good for this region and very good for small business.
That's certainly very welcome. What is your position on the current proposals going through the Assembly on small business rates relief and the proposal to pay for that with a levy on large stores?
I have no problem whatsoever with asking larger stores to pay their fair share. And I think we have to put the interests of this region first. We are not running Northern Ireland for the benefit of a few multinational multiples. We are running this region for the benefit of our people. And what we need is to grow business locally as well as attract investors from outside. So there is no issue whatsoever with me about asking those who can most pay to pay a little bit more.
And your party currently holds the environment brief. That's key to the planning process, which affects so many businesses. And I think, to be fair, we have seen a lot of businesses finding it very difficult, looking at the city airport, looking at other energy plants and so on. What will you do to drive better systems and processes in that department?
Well, we need a planning system that is responsive to the needs of our society, whether they're economic or social. And we don't have that today. So planning reform will continue to be a priority for the SDLP in government and outside government. But the real issue here is the stagnation across all of our government departments. And that is why, above all, I am arguing for a more accountable, more open, more honest system of government, a stronger system of government, where people, whether they're in business, whether they're at home, whether they're elderly or young, where people have a greater say.